Our guest, Professor Jakov, he will present some information about his activity. And by the way, he is working, I mean, he's connected to two types of university. Why? One is in his country of origin, in Egypt, and now for several years, for seven years, he is working in King Khalid. Maybe you change university.
No, King Khalid University.
King Khalid University, it is the most famous university in Saudi Arabia and rather rich. Some people say that when they decided to buy electron microscope, then the dean said, okay, they said, please, we would like to buy one. He said, what, only one?
I hope so.
Okay, thanks, Professor Soldato, for the kind invitation to come to Russia for the first time at Southern Federal University. First of all, our lecture only to show some research activity and our group in Shamsi University and the King Khaled University, which are mainly produce nanomaterial. We are starting nanomaterial since 2011, our laboratory in Shamsi University, and then when I transfer my job to King Khaled, I start also to build a new laboratory in nanomaterials. And not only nanomaterial, you are working nanomaterial, nanocomposite, polymeric material, and other. And this is very interesting for us to have some classification to produce material. I will show you some activity, our group members, some picture, what topics is that we are interested in, what the project are running, some nanostructures that we are produced, and that is it. I approximately take like 20 minutes. First of all, this is, we have two laboratories. The first one is called NLEBA, Nano Science Laboratory for Environmental and Biomedical. And the second one also is AFMOL in King Khaled University for also nano material. We have the strategy to produce the nanomaterial in mass production. So this is mass production, not for industrial. This is only to enhancement our rate of the publication of the paper, because normally if you needed to make like 100 article per year, you cannot prepare one sample per day. This is not easy for us to produce such paper like this. And then we have only mass production of nanomaterial for our laboratory, not for industrial. This is the concept I think I translated from our Holy Quran to Russia. I think it is the clear sentence for us. This is meaning that you must work hard, and also the people will see your work and appreciate your effort. And also the God in the last day will also appreciate you, what you are doing in this life. I hope the translation can be done from Google Translate. This is, I try, but you can see.
Could you return, please, Ben?
Yeah, sure.
I'd like to understand everything. Okay.
Yeah, sure. This, you can translate, or Abdul Aziz can translate.
Feel it. Okay. Человек имеет только то, что он искал. Ну да, наверное, может быть, ну, не имеет, а может, ну, найти только то, что ищет, да? Может быть, я бы так перевел, скорее всего, да? Вот, и что его квест, что это может быть? Абдел-Азиз, could you, квест, квест is not word right. Could you see, what does it mean? Quest means question, or what does it mean? What is the meaning of the phrase?
Okay, the meaning of this, this, the people, he can't obtain anything before, except he go to this goals.
Я понял, да. Если ты, ну, не идешь к этой цели, то ты и не увидишь ничего, ты просто можешь пройти. Если ты идешь собирать грибы, ты должен, ну, понимать, что так идешь по лесу и идешь, да, и грибов не увидишь. Окей.
And his wound, he went obtained, and then all saying, all people they show this goals.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then the goals which he obtained, this will be realized in his life, and will be development, and will be satisfied for this. And then he returned back to Allah.
To the God.
Yeah, to the God. Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah. This is, I like the sentence because.
Yes, but you see that very short written here, but we discussed in just 5 minutes.
Yes. Yes. If you want to explain this sentence, you maybe take one book from Arab to explain this, because it's in many fields.
Yes.
And this applied for all
science
and social.
Okay, all kinds of life. Because science is a part of life, but there is also
I like. Okay, I like.
I would like that we understand everything.
No problem.
We have additional 5 minutes.
I like this sentence because in my defense seminar for associated professor and also my professorship, normally I use such some sentence, and normally I concept with me for many years. So this is, we will continue now. We have some history about NLEBA and some detail about me and also our laboratory in Saudi Arabia, what we have in national collaboration, in international collaboration, some available technique that we have, facilities, and also interested project and some recent publication in ISI journals. This is our trip. We are started from south of Saudi Arabia. So we are started from Abha. Here beside Yemen, I have 300 kilometers from Yemen in the border, and then we travel to Dubai, and then we are started from Dubai to Rostov. This is our campus in Shams University, and also our King Khaled, and this is my faculty of education. Approximately my faculty of education is 95 years old. Started
meeting. Where is Egypt and where is?
This is in Egypt.
Yes.
This is our administrative office of rector and vice rector, and
yes.
This is the symbol of King Khaled, the campus in some behind. So this is our big symbol for King Khaled University, and this is Faculty of Education in Cairo, and this is approximately 95 years old. So we are going to, maybe this is our faculty more older than all Saudi Arabia. Mm-hmm. Then we are start. This is what the concept of why we are interested in material. This is the most important thing. If you are producing a material, then you can catch the technology. If you don't have a material, you don't have nothing. People now started to have many devices, but important in the case, if you have a device, it's important. But we have 100 Russian universities, all are equipped. Who are produce the material? Produce the material, control the science. This is the concept of Professor Tadahiro, that those who dominate material dominate the technology. Requirement for new materials from standpoint of electronic industrial, he is from Japanese electronic engineering in University of Tokyo. Semiconductor, our laboratory in Shams University. I joined the semiconductor lab in Shams University since 1998. Approximately, I finished my bachelor in physics and chemistry in Faculty of Education. And then approximately, I am working now 21 years in the same place, and some of part, you know, of this time are in Saudi Arabia also. So our group, you know, is Professor Dr. Maher Atta. He's graduated from Russia 1981 or 1979. I don't exactly, but he's also learned from here, and also when we return back to my country. He started to build the laboratory as he learned here in Russia. Our second professor, he is dead, Professor Dr. Hassan Hamid graduated from France, and all our members. I am also going to Dr. Mamdouh, Professor Dr. Mamdouh Hadel Aziz, and he is my student, now finished PhD in Hungary. He is very good colleague, and all our friends and also my professor in the groups. So when we are started to make our laboratory about nanoscience, really when I not interested to be in nanoscale material, but when I traveled to Turkey in 2010, I learned how to make sol gel, co-precipitation. I evaporated material, how to see atomic force microscope. So I don't know all of these techniques. My mainly work are using thermal evaporator, we are evaporating charcoal gelide material, make memory devices, make conductivity, that is it. But when I joined Turkey 2010, I learned how to make nanoscale material by low-cost techniques. Then I started to build two laboratories, one in Saudi Arabia and one in my home. The strategy of our laboratory is to make mass production of nano material, and also this is for different applications, for environmental, for memory devices, for other like sensor, energy, solar cell, and other things. And now we are approximately concentrated. We have two problems now in all the countries, environmental and biomedical. Now, due to the technology, due to what we have really industrial, we have a problem in environmental, all are polluted. As we see, so now all, especially in my country, especially the water supplies and other, and also for the health problem now, due to also the more technological production of foods and other, biomedical science is more important. We have many diseases until now not solved, and people try to have some biomedical more science, and this is two categories are very important now that we must going on. This is our group and our friends that we are decided to build this laboratory, and this is the main core of our group, Dr. Gamal, Dr. Mirfat, and Dr. May, and approximately one of this group are together. And this is approximately our main power of our group. Approximately, so me and my wife, together we are physics, so we are working in physics approximately since 2003. And approximately this is all my friends also from other university. This is now when we are open our laboratory in begin of this year, approximately in the end of December 2018. Now we have some students are interested to learn nanoscale material, and we have one big workshop in my home that related to nanoscience, and approximately all the people in nanoscale famous in Egypt are joining our workshop. This is also our laboratory in main power in King Khaled University. So we have Dr. Salem and also Dr. Hamid, and also me and my wife approximately all together until now. So this is important. We have three couples here, you know, me and my wife, and also Dr. Haysam and Dr. Yasmin also one side. And here also we have another couple from Tunisia. So Dr. Abdel Fattah and Dr. Musab, but really I don't have her picture. But approximately this is important that you have a couple in physics to be together. Now this is approximately my progress and all the group progress since 20 years old. This is my maximum effort until now. This is out of my hand. So this is my H index approximately 28. Citation approximately go to 3,000. But we try, you know, we are come to Professor Soldatov to help us to increase our ranking and also our citation and our progress in our work. This is approximately also, this is our publication But years we are started when I am PhD student, approximately I don't have nothing really, only two paper, you know, maximum to have my approved PhD. And you see, you know, the publication are come up and down, it depends about the group that you are working and the people are surrounding. If you have more people around and more people surrounding you, that we could it perform this publication in 2018 and 2019 together. Approximately we are published 85 papers here because we have a huge number of people now join us and more research group are joined, and then we have good achievement. We don't know in 2019 it will come up or come down, no one knows in science what we are doing. I have one strategy to work in science. I only produce science to help myself, my university, my colleague, promotion, PhD student, master degree. So approximately I achieve half of my target. I approximately reached the half, and this is take 20 years. It is not easy, I think, to reach the 500 paper. This is not easy for me. I cannot perform with myself. We must have more friends around to achieve my target. I think if it will be 20 years, then I will be retired after 20 years from now. So this is my strategy, only work, you know, concentrated, you know, what you need exactly. If you have more devices, more high technology, more applications, then it is easy to enhance them to your ranking, your impact factor. But if you are working in moderate level of devices and the application, this is my target to be within 1 to 2 impact factor ISI journal, and this is not easy now. Even you are published in 1 and 2 impact factor, the journal not accept. So we try to make more effort together to enhance the rate of publication and also to enhance the quality of the paper. Now also we have two things important. Increase the number of publication. This is enough to increase the number of publication, to increase the your progress and more high impact factor, then you needed more group and you needed also more technology. This is our national collaboration, approximately 15 university and the center in my home. We have a lot of friends in this with good equipment. Now we have in Fayum University a special center. Approximately my friend there have 55 million Egyptian pound devices. He's very special colleague, graduated from Germany. And now I think he's better with us. And also other center, you know, Atomic Energy Authority, National Research Center and other. Some equipment are also installed. Here are my approximate all my friend. Normally in science, if you don't have friend, it is not easy to work. We cannot work professional in science, not easy. You must have a friend, and then the friend will help you so much for device, for measurement, for analyzing, for open idea. This we are come here to restore. International collaboration. For international collaboration, approximately we have two Russian universities, so Southern Federal University and also Dubna Federal University. We will join us two big projects in Saudi Arabia in research and development. We are submitted 5 months ago and we are waiting the decision. This is very good. Budget, and also it will be give us some more information about transfer the knowledge and to build us our science. Also to all the collaboration with the Poland Institute of Physics and also Serbia Institute of Physics in Belgrade, and we open now France University of Picardy. University of Picardy is a guy from Algeria, and he has his laboratory in solid state devices and the measurement approximately all about thin film technology and cell related devices in solar cell and sensors. Our international collaboration now I think extended with Russia. So now we have our friend is my special professor also Kashevsky and Daniel from Poland. Also another couple in physics, Dr. Nebojša and Dr. Maja from Serbia, and our colleague here, and also our friend from King Abdulaziz University. I think Dr. Ahmed is the first professor in Saudi Arabia that has, I think, more than 400 papers, ISI journal, in very good impact factor, and also has good laboratory in King Abdulaziz University. Here our strategy to have the mass production of nanomaterial via low cost techniques. Approximately we don't have technology, we don't have devices for technology, meaning that we don't have electron beam, we don't have thermal evaporator, laser ablation, no. We are using our low cost technique to produce nanomaterial. So for our strategy that we have microwave hydrothermal, we have soft gel, recombination, biosynthesis, hydrothermal technique, electrochemical tubulation, combustion, and also bio and green synthesis of nanomaterial. This is for nanopowder. And for synthetic technology, we have spin coating, chemical bath, electrochemical tubulation, deep coating spray, and now we are interested more to advance our spray biology. This is most important for us. And then by casting and solution casting. It's not until you fall. Our facility is very easy to build the nanoscale laboratory. Very easy to have 100 lab in nanoscale via our strategy, some glassware, some chemical, important that you have nitrate, and also to have some assisted system for working and producing nanomaterial in low-cost techniques. What's the type of material that we are interested in? We have 8 categories of materials that we are produced really in our laboratory, except one. We will start it, I hope, this year. So we have graphene oxide and graphene, and also we have hydroxyapatite for bone cement engineering. We have lead iodide for polyfuscal solar cell and the transparent solar cell. I'm sorry. Why we are choose hydroxyapatite for biomedical material? After the age of computer and started the people to have computer in home, mobile in every hand, now all the people in next generation of the life in the world will have a problem, especially in bone. So approximately all the people will move like this. You cannot stand up now. All the people have a problem in neck and also in background. And also due to more cars, it will be more accident and can be done. And then we must reduce the bone. This is hydroxyapatite can be used now in different fields, you know, not only to be used in the bone, but also can used as a catalytic material and photocatalytic material. And also it is important that it is used also for shielding of nuclear waste. We are starting this material, just some friend give us idea about hydroxyapatite. And then I don't know hydroxyapatite. Then we are started, oh, this is very interesting. It can work also in bone. So we apply in bone. Oh no, this is, we can use as gamma radiation material. We apply in gamma radiation material. Now, oh no, this is the, it is used 50 years ago. That is in the land, they are put nuclear waste and then shielded by hydroxyapatite. It is very hard material, and it can the nuclear waste surrounded by hydroxyapatite and sustained for 100, 200 years without go to the groundwater. This is the most important of hydroxyapatite. Lead iodide, we have produced lead iodide until now with many doping, but we don't go to the birofuscal. Birofuscal solar cell is most important, but we have a problem. It can reach 22 efficiency, but the problem, it is not stable. So for this, we are only produce lead iodide, and it is not easy to control the structure of lead iodide because it is a layered structure and not easy to control, to have a different form. normally we are have sheet or nano sheet structure of lead iodide. For transparent conductive oxide, for Fe2O, for I2O, now we try to produce in our laboratory. This is cannot done. We don't need, you know, some special technique. We don't need sputtering. Sputtering is the best. This is, can be used in sigma aldrich, but for us, we are using spray pyrolysis. So if you have spray pyrolysis, we can reduce transparent conductive oxide like fluorine dodecyl oxide in film. So I can have a conductive substrate, and then I can build my own device on this conductive substrate. Second, four category of our material that already we are prepared, metal alloys and metal chalcogenide and metal oxide. This is, I think, the field of my wife is metal alloys. And here we are working is the polymeric nanocomposite for different aspects, especially cut-off laser filter. How you can control the beam of the laser? The beam of the laser now are mainly used in different fields, especially for correction the problem of the eye. Then how you can minimize the minimize the intensity of such a field? How you can get 10% or 5% from this beam laser? Now, after working with some polymeric material, as I will show you, some dyes inside polyvinyl alcohol, we can control such beam of the laser used in many operations. This is we don't open until now. This is the carbon dot material, and the carbon dot now have many work in biomedical imaging and other sources. People are producing now fluorescence carbon dot, and this is now we will start it in this soon. Last one, we are using nanomaterial for wastewater treatment by using photocatalytic or absorption process by nanoscale material, different nanoscale material. Even it will be in UV region of light or visible photocatalytic materials. For our project, we have six projects in Shams University. Four we are get, and still two big projects, approximately 4 million Egyptian pounds. We are submitted in wastewater treatment and storage device. The storage device, this is with the China electrochemical cells. And now we are waiting the decision about these two projects. And by these two projects, I will build a new laboratory in my home. For more advanced equipment for analyzing the material for wastewater treatment and also for storage devices. We are waiting the decision for this is the last two project. In King Khaled University, we have seven group. Approximately our rector approved, we are waiting the final decision for three groups with in Institute of Smart Materials, Southern Vedder University, and four groups now are running in different aspects, in different fields also in King Khaled University. Some recent publication done from our group. Approximately, we can go, you know, some to be, you know, like 3.5 impact factor, 4 impact factor, and then come also to our normal 1 to 2 impact factor. So we can go to Ceramic International, we can go to scientific report, and then return back to our normal. This is depend about the quality of the paper that you are produced in your laboratory. But we try to publish ISI with the special journals to be important for our ranking. And this is also some recent publication in single crystal and organic material, and also about sol gel, nickel oxide, and others. Also, our recent publication about lead iodide, we are doped with gold, and this is very good work, really. So we are go to high impact journal like Scientific Report. Important that we must be together to achieve good science. Some result we can obtain with some small applications that we can obtain in our group. So if you have a Dyson-sized solar cell, This is cells as you show. This is contain glass with one layer of conductive glass. We try to make this is first layer and such last layer by stray biolysis to have this is conductive glass instead to buy from Sigma Aldrich. And then we can add titanium oxide as a sheet in the top of the Fe2O and then added some electrolyte and added some dye and then we are using some new dye here. Maybe we don't reach the good efficiency, but we have a good photosensor device. This is our structure of titanium oxide. This is also the duration between the current voltage for the studied Dyson Cyrus solar cell basic about 2.27 dichlor fluorescence dye. And then also we are measured with different light intensity. And this is the power conversion of such device. And here that we are take about the increasing of the current with the applied incident light and also the increase of VOC with increasing the light incident on the device. And I think we don't have good efficiency, but I think our sensing and the photo sensor or low cost sensor is very important in this study. This is another thing about cut-off laser filter that we are using some commercial dye, Congo Red, and attached with some polyvinyl alcohol. If you are studied the XRD diffraction, it shows some semi-crystalline peak, approximately 19.8. And then we have some interesting result that if you are doping the polyvinyl alcohol with some dye at some special doping, we will. This is the absorption band. It's coming from the interaction of dye with DVA, and then by special concentration, approximately we get something is called. There is no any transmitted light here. So according to the dye and their optical band and also absorption bands in the BVA, in some special concentration, we get approximately off of the light absorption. And then by using such a device or polymer sheet, we can control the beam of the laser. Here we can, for the green laser here, also cadmium laser and other, within this range, I can block the light of laser with different percent in this region from 190 until 544 nanometer approximately. Here what we are doing especially when we added dye to the BVA, we have something is called band gap engineering. So the band gap of polyvinyl alcohol started from 4.4 and then by adding such dye, so we are shifting the band gap from 4.4 until 1.8, and then this is important to be have some discussion about our filter to be used to reduce the intensity and the power of the laser. Some of my students in Saudi Arabia, we have a new dye, it's called Byronin Y, and this is the new dye, this is a standard dye, it is normal, but it's using in medical application. For the physicists people, they try to also to use some material that it is also available in the market, and they will try to apply our mind to be used in organic semiconductor. People are using normal dye in staining, in medical, in biomedical. But for our people working in cell film technology, sometimes we needed, you know, some dyes that it is already soluble. Because if the dye is not soluble, what I will do? It is not easy. I must have technology in this case. And for our work, we don't have technology. So we apply spin coating or deep coating by using the dye already soluble in ethanol or DMF or isopropyl or acetone or others to have such kind. By this material, because it is a unique material, we are published five papers from my master degree of my student. Because the dye is new and we apply our mind to get some recent data that we could be used analyzing of this data for many applications. What we exactly looking for now for our devices? Our devices, the important for device, now all our device built on silicon. Until now, the technology in semiconductor or semiconductor devices in electronic are based on silicon, and all the companies only cannot move easily from silicon to very low cost device. The importance of this study that we are deposited Byronin, why, on conductive glass. Why we are using conductive glass in our technology? This is more low cost material and easy to fabricate, and also it can done in the flexible substrate. And also, if you see, this is if you have optoelectronic devices and there is some light incident on the device, there is some thermal heating can come due to the effect of light. By using Fe2O, so if you are considered in only this part of the light, other parts are closed, so we are neglecting the IR signal from this part because there is nothing here, it will come, and the Fe2O only give the visible, approximately visible region here, the maximum of this reaching 81 from 400 until 700. After that, the transmittance of Fe2O, it is compounded, and then the device only absorbing the visible light. Here, if we have, this is this one is belong to the pure Fe2O, but the red one is belong to Byronin Y. So we try to find some detail about the band gap analysis and what we are required for this material to be used in devices. Here there is some nanostructure that we are already published in the literature now. So if you are looking, we have first of all, we have bentacene organic material. Bentacene is the best organic semiconductor can be used in now in the technology, especially in the screen of the mobiles. And in the second page here, we have nickel oxide. This is done by our laboratory, by some gel techniques. And also here we have cadmium oxide with different doping concentration of aluminum. So we have very good nanostructure. And this is picture done by atomic force microscope. For producing also nanomaterial with different sputtering system. We have one sputtering system in Jeddah, in King Abdulaziz University. So my friend there evaporated cobalt dope the zinc oxide, and we have such films also here by done by our laboratory surgery techniques. We can dope it the chrome dope the nickel oxide. If we don't apply our mind to using spin coating and our surgery method, I must have a machine with approximately $0.5 million, and this is not easy to available, but it's been put is available in everywhere. So we apply surgery technique to apply this is very good structures. For magnesium oxide, because also now we are using and as antibacterial and antifungi, so we are producing such a nanoplate magnesium oxide by using metal source. So if you have a metal source of magnesium and added hydrogen peroxide and then apply the signal of microwave under special time, pressure and temperature, we obtain nanoplate magnesium oxide, and this is published in surgery technology. Other AFM zinc oxide, also this is by changing the ratio of stabilizing agent inside the nanostructure, we got something nanofiber zinc oxide with different morphology as we are see. Recent we are published molybdenum doped Ag3BO4, and this is visible photocatalytic material, and We apply different concentration of molybdenum, and also we have some crystal, and also coated with some secondary phase at very high concentration of molybdenum. And other picture, we have manganese coated lead iodide, aluminum manganese coated lead iodide, and also we have lead iodide sheet. It is not easy for us until now to control the morphology of lead iodide. It is very hard. Last one here, we have nano sheet graphene oxide that we have produced in our laboratory with superimposed of XRD with the pattern as we are seeing in this. For hydroxyapatite, we try, a lot of people work with hydroxyapatite, but we try, you know, to find, you know, some, if you are found in the literature, it is not easy to find the way to work in the barrel of the people. So we have something, is potassium iodide, dubbed with hydroxyapatite, and we have one good colleague that she can use this hydroxyapatite also for wastewater treatment, and the bacteria will be inside the solution. So we have, you know, something like the bacteria with catalytic material as hydroxyapatite, we can use also for wastewater treatment. And we have published this paper in Ceramic International. Other papers that my friend Dr. May, also Nickel, dubbed AG3PO4 silver phosphate. This is more visible material, and this is visible material now is take more important now in the literature for wastewater treatment or visible photocatalytic materials. Here also we have continue our spin coating. You know, still spin coating can give some good structure about cover dot zinc oxide, and also here from, this is done I think in Turkey, but this is the 10 dot zinc oxide. It is in our laboratory. Finally, I think the best way to make science that the people must be together. This is the most concept now. You cannot work individually. Say that we have 10 years individual approximately until retirement, you cannot be alone. You need people around, and the more people around, maybe you can catch some new idea about science, and then you can also win Nobel Prize. This is the most important picture for me, that if you are be together, then you can make something good for our life. This is thank you. I just show my progress in King Khaled and in Shams University, and we hope the next visit we can have something unique with Southern Vedra University. Thank you very much.
Okay, any questions?